Few days ago, a friend of mine in China sent me some interesting news. I just found that Mate 30 is cheaper than the other regions of the world. Hold on, we need to stand Huawei at the moment. What comes in your mind is the trade, the sanction, the government security, and Google. Yes, we've had enough, but is there a way of using this beautiful handset legally? If you concern yourself on tech, you're acquainted with the best smartphone of the year. Maybe, that's my impression, but starting with its camera, the horizontal display, the processor, and many other cool features. The Mate 30 delivers its qualities. Without doubt, the Mate 30 is a wish of any tech enthusiast. With that being said, if you love tech, please consider subscribing. On the current market, the Mate 30 is the best smartphone camera, topping out the table of the XO Mark with just 3 marks in front of the Samsung Note 10. It's the highest in video light sensitivity, and on that field it's just 7 times more effective than the others. It's super efficient video stabilization. Wait, stop, I'm not talking about the specs, but what this phone can really do is amazing, and I believe if the phone was allowed to use Google services, without doubt, it will be among the top 3 best-selling smartphone of the year. An interesting fact, it's been reported to have sold 1 million units within 3 hours of the initial launch day in China only. So, let's get back to our topic. Early this year, when the tension began, Huawei moved its resources back to China, making its improvement in sales over the region and reported shipped more than 36 million units. But what if the sales are increasing in China but dropping elsewhere in the world? If that would be a way, the main reason would be Google. So, how can you own an Android smartphone with a less perfect Android operating system? Shortly after the launch, that was the main topic, and LZ Play came as an option. You would install and it completely changed the core system setting on the device. This would enable users to install most Google apps and services. Just a few days, the security of the device was doubtful. Huawei may have realized this was a mistake and suggested some users to restore the Android version. The new option is the virtual machine operating system. So, how does it work? A virtual machine installs an operating system. It means it can run another complete Android system through an application. And to avoid any specific restriction, the virtual machine operating system is controlled by the host system. So, in order to understand the virtual machine, let's say for example I'm using Windows on my PC, and with some work or school project even desires I want to install Linux, I can install Linux virtually and the two system software will work in parallel. Even though it's a solution, the virtual machine holds some issues. The apps launch a little slower, YouTube plays the video at lower resolution as much as 480p. And the frame rate is between 25 to 30. The system is a little sluggish compared to the operating system of the phone itself. Personally, it was in plan of the Mate 30, but since the launch, I'm still holding myself to see the end of this handset. I said before, if you like tech updates, please consider subscribing. So, let's meet again.